In our channel, we have seen how to use Animaker to create 2D animations for a lot of different purposes. But do you know that you can create whiteboard animations using Animaker? Yes, you can. Many of our subscribers asked us to teach them how to create whiteboard animations. This video is for you guys. So without further ado, let's begin. To create any video, you need a script. A script is a text or the audio that is added to the video. This is the script of the whiteboard video that we are going to create today. Keep the script ready before you start. Visit the website of Animaker and sign up for a new account. Select the following options to create a new video project. This is the interface of the Animaker application. In the center is the workspace. On the right hand side is the scene section. Scenes are similar to what you call slides in a presentation. Similar to how several slides combine to form a presentation, several scenes combine to form a video. On the bottom is the timeline. By default, the animation timeline will be open. You also have a video and audio timeline. And the last one is the camera timeline. On the left hand side is the library. It has different elements like animated characters, properties and music tracks that you will need to create the whiteboard animation video. And the best thing is all these assets are copyright free. Let's start with adding a character to the scene. Go to the character section in the library and select a character. On the right hand side, you can notice the actions tab. There are more than 500 different actions. Let's select the waving action. You can see that the character looks colorful, but the characters in whiteboard animations are white in color. So let's change it. You can see a bunch of options appearing along with the character. This is called the item menu. It has all the features needed to edit this character. Every element added to the workspace will have an item menu of its own. Click on the change color option in the item menu to customize the colors. You can see that the character is merging along with the background because of the white color. We have to change the color of the background. Click anywhere on the workspace and you can see a new color palette option appearing at the bottom. Add a bit of black. Not much, but a little enough to make the character visible. If you select the character on the timeline, you can see a purple colored bar. It represents the duration for which this character is going to be visible. You can move this bar and control the character's visibility. Let's add an animation effect to the character. We know that one of the significant features in whiteboard videos is the appearance of the human hand. Select the settings option from the item menu. On the right hand side, you can see two options named Enter Effect and Exit Effect. Click on the Enter Effect option. I'm going to select the option named Hand from Left. Now you can see a pink color part on the timeline. It represents how long the effect is going to be. You can control the duration of the effect by extending its length. Let's see how to add text to the scene. To add text, go to the text section in the library and select a text box. Now type the text that you want. With the options under the settings tab, you can customize the text. Let me change the font style, size, and color. Let's apply the enter animation effect to the text. Go to the bottom of the settings tab and click on the enter effect option. Now select the handwrite option. Optimize the duration of the animation effect using the option in the timeline. Let's have a preview of the scene. You can see that the scene's duration is long. By default, the duration of a scene is 10 seconds. You can increase or decrease its duration using the plus and minus options in the timeline. Let's reduce the scene's duration to 5 seconds. To add a new scene, use the new scene option over here. Or you can duplicate the current scene using the duplicate option and edit over it. I'm using the duplicate option. Let's change the character's action. Let's edit the text. The creation of scene 3 is similar to the previous scene, so I'm fast forwarding this part of the video. I have completed creating the scene number 3 and scene number 4. For scene 4, I want to highlight this text in the center. Go to the properties section and select this circle. Reduce its size and keep it over the text. Right now you can see that it is hiding the text. Select the option Move to Last present at the bottom of the settings tab. I'm going to group this number and the circle together by selecting them and applying the option Group from the item menu. Once you group the objects, you can apply a common animation effect to them. Following the same method, I'm going to complete the last scene. For the last scene, once again we are going to use a property and highlight the text. But this time we are going to use a different shape and apply a different animation effect. Go to the properties section and select the square. Reduce its size on both the sides and convert it into a line. Change its color to black and apply the animation effect, wipe from left. I want one more of this line. Instead of creating it from scratch, duplicate the current one by pressing Ctrl C and Ctrl V. If you are using Mac, press Command C and Command V. Now just adjust its position in the scene. In the same way, you can use the different objects from the properties section and improve your video. You can also apply transition effect between the scenes using the Add Transition Effect option over here. As the last step, let's add the music track to the video. Go to the music section in the library. Here you can find more than 30,000 copyright free music tracks. Hover over a track to hear it. Click on it to apply it to the video. Now you can see the newly added music track on the timeline. If you further click on the track, you'll get a few more options. You can have a preview of the track, control its volume, duplicate it and delete it if you want and add a new track. To have a preview of all the scenes together, use the preview option at the top. To download the video, go to the Publish option at the top, click on the Download Video option and then Download option. Now you know how to create a whiteboard animation video using Animaker. Aren't you excited to create your own whiteboard video? Then use the link in the description and create yours.